Last video we did a relatively easy question. Let's proceed to just form our understanding. First we'll make the Gantt chart, right? Gantt chart always starts from zero. Any process arriving at zero? I guess no. The first process is arriving at 2 units of time, process P4, right? Now it is the only process right now, so assign P4. How much time it required? It is asking for 3 units of time, burst time, right? So schedule it, 2 plus 3, 5. Now till 5 minutes of time, what process have come? 1 and 6, both have same arrival time. Now you would be confused which to schedule first. Now in this case, when the arrival time is same, the process number will come into picture. Whichever has the lowest process number will be scheduled. Now you'll be thinking, what if the process number gets same? No, it won't happen. Process number is always unique, remember that. So we'll be assigning P1 now. How much time it is asking for? It is asking for 2 units of time, 2 and 7. Now till 7 units of time, any process has arrived? No. Now process P6, it is asking for 1 unit of time, 8. Now till 8 units of time, any process has arrived? No. No process has arrived. So at 9 units of time, one process is arriving. What to do? We'll leave it idle for 1 unit of time. This is important. Most of the time you will do error here, so it is important that you make the Gantt chart and see when the process is arriving and do the correct analysis. Now process P2, how much time it is asking for? 8 units of time, 8, 17. Now to 17 units of time, these two also have come, which has arrived earlier? P3. So assign P3, asking for 9 units of time, 17 plus 9, 26. Now P5, asking for 8 units of time, right? Asking for 8 units of 26 plus 8, that will be 34, correct? So now write the CT here. P5 has been completed 34, then the P3. P3 has been completed at 26, then P2 has been completed at 17, P6. P6 has been completed at 8 units of time, then 8. P1 has been completed at 7 units of time, and P4 has been completed at 5 units of time. TAT, I have already told you, CT minus AT, 5 minus 2, 3, 7 minus 3, 4, 8 minus 3, 5, 17 minus 9, your 8, right? 26 minus 12, 14, right. 34 minus 15, that is 19. If you add these up, you'll get 59. Then the waiting time, it's simply TAT minus burst time. 3 minus 3, 0, 4 minus 2, 2, 5 minus 1, 4, 8 minus 8, 0, 14 minus 9, 5, 19 minus 8, it's 11. Then if you add those up, you'll get your waiting time to be, let's add those up, 16 plus 4, 20, 22. So 22, now average waiting time will be 22 divided by 5, that will be 4.4. your average TAT is 59 divided by 5, 11.8. just your analysis should be correct. It doesn't matter how, if your answer is correct or not, your analysis should be correct, okay? 59 divided by 6, it will be 8.83, and this will be 22 divided by 6, that will be 3.18467, okay? This is the answer. Your analysis should be correct, and this is how you do it. Thank you.